And let's bring in right now one of the most famous players from the undefeated 1972 Dolphins Hall of Famer and fullback Larry Csonka. Mr. Csonka, it is an honor. Thanks for joining us.
It's good to be here, Jake.
So we're used to seeing teams come through the White House all the time to celebrate with the president. You guys are kind of a big deal. Is this an important event for you?
I think so. It's any reason that we have after some 40 or 41 years to get together is always appreciated. The fact that we are called to the White House made it even more special.
What's a bigger deal, being inducted in the Hall of Fame or this? Which one is bigger?
Oh, I don't know. That's a pretty tough comparison. I don't know if either's bigger. I think within the confines of the game, certainly the Hall of Fame is bigger. As far as the public is concerned and the following of the team and the notoriety of the team, certainly going to the White House is bigger in that respect.
So some of your former teammates, Jim Langer, Manny Fernandez, decided not to attend today because they really don't like President Obama's policies and politics. What's your take on that?
Well, that's a political issue. If some of the fellas, this is a country where you have your freedom of speech, freedom to express your politics, freedom to do what you want to do. And I think that's exemplified by the fact that some of the team decided not to come. And that's the political side of it. On another note, the team side of it, a reason to get together was greatly appreciated by myself and the other fellows here. And we kind of got a hoot out of being asked to come to the White House and meet the President of the United States.
There's been a lot of talk about why Nixon didn't invite you. Obviously, he was a huge Redskins fan, and he had Coach Allen to the White House 2 weeks before the Super Bowl. What's your take on why Nixon didn't have you guys come?
Well, I think President Nixon must have surely had his own reasons. I don't know what they were, but I think that also was a time before it was really a regular thing to bring the Super Bowl champions to the White House. So while in some respects it may seem that we were neglected, I don't necessarily feel that way. I think it was even neater to be 40 or 41 years later in a unique situation that was even more unique after 40 or 41 years. Then coming to the White House to celebrate the thing with a pretty unique president that we have right now.
And before you go, sir, one of my favorite things about the 72 Dolphins is that you have a champagne toast every year when the last undefeated team loses. You came close a couple years ago. Before the Patriots lost the Super Bowl, they were undefeated. Do you think that you will ever see another undefeated team?
I hope not. I hope not to see another undefeated team, but certainly if it happens, you have to recognize the fact. In 85, it was the Bears. A few years ago, it was the New England Patriots. Seems like there's always someone knocking at the door trying to climb the mountain. But right now, we're still alone, sitting on the peak.
Of course, in 85, the Bears would have been undefeated if it weren't for a certain team from
Coach,
Miami.
Coach Shula brought that up to the president when he was talking about being a Bears fan and how they only missed by one game. And Shula asked the president, what team was that that beat the Bears that year? He always had great timing.
It was, of course, the Miami Dolphins. Larry Csonka, thank you so much for your time. Congratulations 41 years later.
Thank you, Jake.